Have you seen SPF on your sunscreen bottles, but you don't know exactly what it means? Let me break it down for you. SPF stands for Sun Protection Factor. It measures how well a sunscreen can protect you from the sun. The higher the SPF in your sunscreen bottle, the more protection you'll get from sunburn. Trivia time! What do you think the ideal SPF number is? 15, 30, 50, or 200? You'll find out at the end of the video. But first, let me tell you what SPF protects you from. Ultraviolet rays, or UV rays. They are invisible, but you can still feel them on your skin. There are two types, UVA rays and UVB rays. UVA rays are connected to skin aging. UVB rays cause sunburn. A quick way to remember this is A for aging and B for burning. UVA and UVB rays damage the DNA in your skin cells and can play a role in causing skin cancer. SPF usually refers to how much protection you get from UVB rays, but experts recommend protecting yourself from both types of rays. To do that, look for broad spectrum on sunscreen labels, which means it'll help protect from both UVA and UVB rays. Now, how is the SPF number for a bottle of sunscreen decided? In a lab, researchers put sunscreen on a patch of skin. Then, they expose that skin to UV rays. They see how long it takes for the skin to redden, and then they compare it to how long it takes for unprotected skin to redden. After that, they divide two numbers, how long it took for the skin with sunscreen to redden, and how long it took for the unprotected skin to redden, and that's the SPF number. True or false? SPF is related to the amount of time you spend in the sun. It's false. That's actually a common myth. Some people think that if you use SPF 15, for example, then you can stay in the sun 15 times longer than usual. But that's not true. How much of the sun's energy you're exposed to and how quickly you burn actually depends on a lot of things, like your skin type. For example, if you have fair skin, you might burn faster than others, how much sunscreen you use, and if you're using enough to cover your whole body, and how often you reapply it. If you're sweating a lot or in the water, you'll need to reapply more often. Remember the question I asked you at the beginning? What do you think the ideal SPF number is? Well, a dermatologist told me the answer is 50. That's if you're going to be spending a lot of time playing outside. However, for everyday use, a minimum of SPF 30 is enough. But you have to use your sunscreen properly for it to work. That means following the instructions on the package, like putting on the sunscreen 10 to 15 minutes before you go outside, and reapplying every 90 minutes or after swimming or sweating. I hope you learned a lot about SPF. For CBC Kids News, I'm Sabrina Erin.